Right, good morning all of you. So in this session, right, two mating gays have 20 teeth and 40 teeth, right, 40 involute teeth. So that means the profile of the gay tooth is involute profile of module 10 millimeters, right, and 20 degrees pressure angle. So the given gauge system is 20 degrees involute system, right? So with a module of 10 millimeters, number of teeth on two gear wheels, 20 and 40 respectively, right? The addendum on each wheel, is to be made of such a length. The addendum on each wheel is to be made of such a length that line of contact on each side of the pitch point has half the maximum possible length. Right? Read out carefully. The addendum on each wheel is to be made such that line of contact on each side of the pitch point. So, pitch point will have two sides, left side and right side. Left side path is nothing but approaching path, and right side path is called recessing path. Right? So, the length of line of contact on left side of the pitch point is called length of approach if the pinion rotates in clockwise direction, or the driver rotates in the clockwise direction. So one side will have length of path of approach, and on the other side you will have line of recess, right? So these lengths, length of path of approach and length of passes, a path of recess, is given as half the maximum possible length, So determine the addendum height for each gear wheel. That means for gear as well as pinion. The length of path of contact and the arc of contact and the contact ratio. So you are asked to find out the addendum height of each gear wheel, length of path of contact and arc of contact, and contact ratio. Okay, so write down the data. Now look at the board. Now tell me the data. What is the type of system here? 20 degrees involute system. 20 degrees involute system. So the pitch angle is 20 degrees. Okay. Then number of teeth on. So here we have two gear wheels, right? Number of teeth on pinion. Generally, here in our interference terminology, number of teeth on pinion is 20. Number of teeth on gear is given. The larger one will be considered as the gear, and smaller one will be considered as the pinion here, right? Then what is given? The pressure angle is 20 degrees. And what is the addendum value? Addendum is equal to 10 mm. Then any other parameters? So you are asked to find out the addendum height, right? Now first you draw the figure here. So this is base circle of pinion, and let us take the base circle of gear. Gear is a larger one, right? In between these you draw a tangent. So let us take this is, let us take the driver is the, okay, the driver. So this is O1 and gear is the driven member, right? this is pitch point, right? So this point is M and this point is F, right? So these are nothing but base circles. Base circle 1, base circle 2. So first you must be able to draw this circle. The point where both the pitch circles will touch with each other is nothing but pitch point. So this is pitch circle. Pitch circle 2, pitch circle 1. Then, so this is MN is the limiting points of tangency, right? These are the interference limiting points, and your path of contact is within this region. Within this region, so generally path of contact is represented with two letters, some K and L. So this is L and this is K. How do you get point K? When the addendum circle of gear wheel, when the addendum circle of gear wheel intersects with the tangent, intersects with the tangent. Let us take, I am using another color here. This is addendum circle of gear intersecting with the tangent. So this is K. Similarly, the addendum circle of pinion, so this is L. Now KL is KL. So L is point of disengagement, K is point of engagement, KL is path of approach, sorry, path of contact. Path of contact. Okay, so KL can be split into KP plus PL. So KP is path of approach plus path of recess. Now it is given that the pitch point, the length of this path of contact on both sides of the pitch point is half the maximum length, the maximum possible length. What is the maximum possible path of approach? P to M. If path of approach is beyond this point M, then the interference occurs. So that's why maximum path of approach is PM. Similarly, maximum path of recess is PN. Right? Your path of approach and recess value should not exceed this value. If it exceeds this value, then the interference occurs. Okay, now it is given that path of approach or path of recess is half the maximum possible length. So here I am denoting path of approach as KP, that is equal to half the maximum possible length. What is the maximum possible? MP is the maximum possible approach, so MP by 2. Similarly, maximum path of recess is PN. So path of recess is designated with let us P and L here. PL is equal to PN by 2. PN by 2. PN by 2. So what is PN and MP from the formula? So this is a right angle triangle. From the center, you will have a right angle triangle here. And from this center, you will have a right angle triangle here. Okay. Now, what is MP? MP is equal to, what is this distance of P from center? that is equal to pitch circle radius, small r here, and here the pitch circle radius is capital R. If this is small r and this is a pressure angle pi, right, this will become opposite side and this will become adjacent side. Now from triangle O1MB, from triangle O1MB, sine pi, sine pi is equal to MP divided by O1P, right? MP is unknown here, O1P is smaller, implies MP is equal to small r into sine pi, Similarly, from triangle O2NP, sine pi is equal to, tell me sine pi, this is O2NP, this is pi here, then NP RPN divided by O2P, therefore PN divided by capital R implies PN is equal to capital R sine pi, So that means here, therefore, path of approach KP is equal to MP by 2, MP is small r sine phi by 2, right? Similarly, PN, PL is equal to PN by 2, that is capital R sine phi by 2, right? But what is path of approach formula? Path of approach formula, we know small r a square minus r square cos square phi under root minus r sine phi. Similarly here, capital R a square minus capital R square cos square phi minus capital R sine phi. This is standard equation of path of approach and path of faces here. Now if you equate these two, right, you can find out the value of R a. But what about R value here? But R is equal to, what is small r? Small r is the pitch circle radius of pinion, that you can express in terms of module and number of pin. Small r is equal to MP by 2. Similarly, cap r is equal to M capital T by 2. Okay, M is 10 mm and T is 20 by 2. That is equal to 100 mm. 100 mm. Right, then here it is 10 into capital T is 40 by 2. That is 200 mm. Okay, now you have capital R, small r, and you can substitute here, right? Phi is 20 degrees, only unknown here it is, unknown is R a, right? So from this equation, KP equation, calculate R a value. What is small r a? Small r a is the addendum circle radius of pinion. Similarly, from PL equation, calculate capital R a value, So small r a and capital R a, small r a is equal to addendum circle radius. Right, that is equal to capital R a is equal to addendum circle radius of gear, and here it is of pinion. Right, so you get these two values, small RA value, capital RA value. Once you have small RA and capital RA value, you can find out the addendum value. How do you get addendum? Addendum is equal to the radial distance between addendum circle minus fist circle radius, RA minus R, RA minus R. Similarly, you can take A is equal to, in terms of capital RA minus capital R, you can get the values. First parameter you can find out. Right? Are you clear? So first you must be able to represent this figure. Right? So, and the condition is given, the path of approach and path of recess is equal to of the maximum value, of the maximum value. Maximum value is nothing but the extreme points you need to consider. What are the extreme points? M and N are the extreme points. Right? So this is MP path of approach, PN is maximum path of recess. Right? Your actual path of approach is of the maximum approach. Your actual path of recess is half the maximum path of recess. That's what I have considered here in these two cases. Right? And write down the value of MP and PN from these two triangles. MP is equal to R sine phi. PN is equal to R cos phi. Sorry, capital sine. Then path of approach.